Can you ask him to stand it up? Hayden. Now that there are people in it, soaks it up. Check with Stuart. Get a view from Stuart as well, Rebecca. Good morning, everyone. Should we take our seats? Should we just commit this time to the Lord in prayer? Rebecca will lead us.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just come before you now with grateful hearts, and we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this church. We thank you for each other. And most of all, Lord, we just thank you for you. May you be the front and center of our purpose this morning for being here. Just open our hearts and our minds to what you would have say to us through the speaking of your word. Bless Ian this morning, we pray, and just receive our worship and our adoration. Lord, we come before you, as I say, with grateful hearts, and we just commit this service to you now in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Well, one practical thing that I have forgotten is I don't have a handheld mic at the front. I don't think so. If someone could cover that, that would be super. Right, should we stand? We'll sing the hymn, Thine Be the Glory, Risen Conquering Son. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory thou, O death, has won. Angels in bright raiment rolled the stone away, kept the folded grave clothes where thy body lay. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory thou, O death, has won. Lo, Jesus meets us, risen from the tomb. Lovingly he greets us, scatters fear and gloom. Let the church with gladness hymns of triumph sing. For her Lord now liveth, death has lost its sting. In our strife, make us more than conquerors through thy deathless love. Lead us in thy triumph to thy home above. Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory Thine be the glory.
Thine be the glory, risen conquering Son. Endless is the victory Thou, O death, hast won.
Please be seated for the Bible reading. This will be brought by Alex.
Morning. We've got two readings this morning. The first is from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 to 5. Therefore, having this ministry by the mercy of God, we do not lose heart. But we have renounced disgraceful, underhanded ways. We refuse to practice cunning or to tamper with God's word, but by the open statement of the truth, we would commend ourselves to everyone's conscience in the sight of God. And even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For what we proclaim is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord, with ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. 1 Corinthians 1, verse 22 to 24. For Jews demand signs and Greeks seek wisdom, but we preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and folly to Gentiles. But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. Amen. Amen.
Shall we stand if we're able? We'll continue our worship before we come before the Lord in prayer, as high as the heavens.
As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are your ways to mine. Ways so perfect, they never fail me. I know you are good all the time. Despite it all, yet I will sing through good or bad. Yet I will worship, for you remain the same, King of kings. You are the voice of hope. Where there seems to be no way, you make it possible. You are the Prince of Peace. Amidst adversity, my lips will shout for to you, the Most High. You were the one before time began. There's nothing beyond your control, my confidence, my assurance, rest in your same, King of kings. You are the voice of hope, the anchor of my soul. Where there seems to be no way, you make it possible. You are the Prince of Peace. Amidst adversity, my lips will shout for joy. Are overtaking when I feel forsaken, God is by my side. Constant when the ground is shifting and my head is spinning, God will hold me tight. My hope is in you. Strength is renewed. You are my peace. You are my peace. You infuse my heart again with life. My confidence through every fear. I will trust you, Jesus, my supply. Darkness sometimes comes to taunt me, tells me I'm unworthy of the Father's love. But I will turn again to Jesus, unashamed in weakness, covered by his blood. My hope is in you. My strength is renewed. You are my peace. You are my peace. You infuse my heart again with life. My confidence through every fear. I will trust you, Jesus, my supply. There is blessing in the waiting. There is refuge in the storm. There is comfort in abiding. We are safe in the arms of God. You are my peace. You are my peace. You infuse my heart again with life. My confidence. I will trust you, Jesus, my supply.
Please take your seats. Eileen is going to lead us in prayer.
magic touch, obviously. Sometimes, when we pray, we think, oh goodness, what's the use of praying that? It can't possibly happen. But I remember an old hymn. I'm always remembering old hymns. And some of them are wonderful. You are coming to a king. Large petitions therefore bring. For his love and power are such, none can ever ask too much. And the angel told Mary, with God, nothing shall be impossible. So with these thoughts, let us come to our all-powerful, loving Father. And so, Lord, we do come to you, thanking you. Will be a difficult day because they haven't heard from people they hope to hear from. Or they're remembering mothers who are no longer there. And so we pray for those, for comfort, for those who find it difficult. And also for those who have longed for children and never had them. Those who are aunts but never mothers, please will you help them too? May they not feel left out. And we thank you that you understand, because you are the father who has many children who don't remember you. And so we come to you and ask you to bless all mothers. Thank you for those for whom today is a happy day. And in their rejoicing, may they remember you and remember that you are one who is father and mother for those in need. And we pray for those who would love to be here, love to be with their children, but cannot for various things. Those in prison, whether for their own fault or whether because they have proclaimed you in a place where it is not wise to do so. Please comfort them. That's a big thing, but you're able. And so we pray for those who are unjustly imprisoned, that you will be with them and may they get justice. We pray for those who are ill, that you will be with them, and if it is your will, you will make them better. Thank you that you know better than we do what is right. Sometimes you give healing down on this earth. Sometimes you give complete healing by taking them to yourself. And so, in our hearts, we just bring the names to you. We don't have to tell you what they need. You know it. So we bring names to you. Thank you, Lord, that you hear and you are able to answer. You are able to do what is best. And so we do bring those who need your salvation. Please, may they hear your voice. They may not be in this church today, but you're not limited to a church, so please speak to them. And for those who are needing your provision in this country, we pray for those who are finding it hard to keep warm. Thank you for a warm day. May they be able to get sunshine, to get out in the warmth. Thank you for those places that are open to give warm rooms. And we pray that people who perhaps don't normally go to a church may go because it's a nice warm place. May they be welcomed and feel, well, maybe I'll try that next Sunday. So we just pray for people in need and those who need food, shelter, clothing, so many things. We pray for those who have been in the various disasters we hear about on the TV. Oh Lord, please undertake for them and those who are trying to help them, that there's so much that they must see which must be heartbreaking. Please help and strengthen and comfort them. May they be able to sleep they need because they're so tired. May these things not prey on their minds. And so, Lord, we come home and ask you to bless in this service. Bless Ian as he speaks to us. Bless every part. And when we listen and get something from you, O Lord, may no one go home feeling that was a waste of time. I didn't get anything. And so will you just give them a special blessing? And any who find it difficult to hear, may they be able to hear. But if not, please, will you just murmur something in their ears? You're not limited by deafness, so thank you that you can yourself speak to them. So we bring these things, they're very great, but you are able. And we ask this all in your precious name. Amen.
Should we stand if we're able? Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he. Sing a new song to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Clothed in rainbow of living color, flashes of lightning, rolls of thunder. Blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to you, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation
nation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Filled with wonder, awestruck wonder at the mention of your name. Jesus, your name is power, breath and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you.
Shout to the